just needs to open and the love starts. Today is such a day.
Yes.
I'm trying not to cry. I'm both nervous and emotional, so excuse me for my shakiness. So we're gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Jeremy and Kristen. For them, this marriage is both a pledge of enduring love and an expression of their commitment to each other. For the rest of us, this marriage is an occasion where we're reminded of the bonds of our own families and friends and how important and wonderful these bonds are to us.
Maybe you should group hug.
Sorry, I'm not the one who's supposed to be clear. Marriage is dedication. You give yourself, your life, and love into the hands of the one you love. You do so trustingly and generously. By the same token, each of you receives a gift, the life and love of the other. You receive this gift not only from the one you love, but also from the parents who brought you in to the world and reared you, and from the personal world of friends, all of you guys, and family who are joined in friendship and faith in your marriage. Mark Twain once said that, quote, a marriage makes two fractional lives whole. It gives to two purposeless lives, not that these two lives were purposeless, a work and doubles the strength of each to perform it. It gives to two questioning natures a reason for living. It brings a new gladness to the sunshine and a new fragrance to the flowers and new beauty to the earth, a new mystery to life.
All right. Nervous. I wasn't nervous until just now. Hi, Jeremy. Vow to love you, Kristen, and care for you as long as we both shall live. I pledge myself this day to trust and appreciate you. I acknowledge our individuality and respect the natural space that will reside comfortably between us. I promise to bridge that space with open communications, silent understanding, and heartful compassion. I promise to act as loving so as to be loving. I promise to respect and cherish your uniqueness and to support and comfort and strengthen you through life's joys and sorrows. I will help you when you need help, and I will turn to you when I need help. I'll choose you as the person to whom I will spend my life. I gladly accept the responsibilities that come with our relationship. I love you and pledge my fidelity all the days of our life.
Hi, Kristen. Vow to love you, Jeremy, and care for you as long as we both shall live. I pledge myself this day to trust and appreciate all of you. I acknowledge our individuality and respect the natural space that will reside comfortably between us. I promise to act loving so as to be loving. I promise to respect and cherish your uniqueness and support, comfort, and strengthen you through life's joys and sorrows. As our lives change, I will be the champion, support, and the champion that you will need. I choose you as the person with whom I will spend my life. I gladly accept the responsibilities that come with our relationship. I love you and pledge my fidelity all the days of our lives.
Traditionally, the marking of the passage to the status of husband and wife is marked by the exchange of rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. Love freely given has no giver and no receiver. For each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings remind you always of the vows you have taken here today. And I want to say one more. So, this is a tiny little poem. I think it's by by Kabir, and it reminded me of, Kristen was telling me about just her philosophy of love the other day, just when we were up in Lake Dillon, and I was really moved by how accepting she is of my very, very unique brother, you know, and how willing to accept all parts of him, and then this poem came to me, and it seems like appropriate for the ring. Look what happens when the scale stops. Look what happens to the scale when love holds it. It stops working.
This ring is a gift for you. Symbolizes my desire that you be my wife and my faithful.
This ring is a gift for you that symbolizes my wish to be you, for you to be my husband for this day.
Congratulations, you two. I now have the honor, due to the power vested in me based on some online source. State of Colorado, thank goodness. And more importantly, by this crazy, amazing couple in front of me, to pronounce you husband and wife.
This is going to be our first kiss as a married couple. I used to sing songs to her online all the time, back when we were Skyping all the time. So I figured to make our first kiss even more memorable, I would sing you a little tune. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me.
Yeah. We wanted to thank you all for coming out here and making a journey to celebrate this with us and enjoy this with us. We are represented far and wide, as we can see, and there's so many people I could point out, but I think if you mingle, you'll get to know everyone, and my heart is full. So, thank you for coming, and we will eat momentarily, and you can drink lots.
Lots. Lots.